Good evening, everybody. This is Fezzik Jr., and we are playing Lumber Tycoon. Tonight, I am joined by my friend Brendan Boss here. He's hired me to do a small job tonight. As you can see, I am running low on cash because of a build that I've been working on over there. We'll get to that here in a minute. And been trying to kind of keep it secret. I did try recording a couple videos on it earlier, and it just didn't work out very well. And so this will be a reveal video, I guess. Hopefully that'll work out pretty well. Anyway, so we're gonna get started on the work first. So our friend Brendan here needs some large floors, 25 of them, in fact. 3, 4, 5. I'll straighten out. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, we'll start off with those 10. All right. He's working on a build on his base, and he does not have the power. I luckily enough do have the power. I was given a very generous donation by a gentleman I met on here a while back, and he walked me through the process of getting the power, and really great time. And so now I am using it to both help out Brendan here and do a little bit of work for lumber. So that's what we're doing. Try not to do asking for money or any of that kind of stuff. I like to work for it. So that's what we're doing. Get on up there. There we go. So I had got some pretty good plans here for Thanksgiving coming up. I am going to be spending it with a stepbrother of mine and some in-laws as well. And we're just going to have a good old time. Probably watch the football game and eat lots of turkey and just hang out and visit and enjoy some time off. Enjoy some time with the family. I hope you guys have get to enjoy some time with your family during the holidays and stay warm and fed and don't have to work too hard. For those of you that do have to work, I've worked many a Thanksgiving in the past before I got regular job, so to speak. Oh yeah. So for those of you who haven't seen it before, if you can see more details on it in previous videos, but there is a way to make the amber axe swing faster than it should by using the speed of the previous axe. I'll show you what I mean here. Oh, I messed that one up. Let's try it over here. Messed it up again. What are you doing? There it goes. Anyway, it works really good on thick trees like goldwood. Get over here. Ones that take a lot of strikes. A little small. Get up there. Come on. You can do it. There you go. Come on. What are you doing? Lag. Okay. So, Okay, we're going to get these guys built up here. We're going to throw them on his base. And then I will show you guys the build that I've been working on. Here across the road. Tags. Alright, so that'll make it easier for me to get it over to where his base is. Huh? There we go, and then we just need 5 more. 2, 3, 4, and 5. All right. He is loading. I will throw this guy up there, and this guy up there. Ah, get back over here. Come on. You can do it. Get up here, little piece. No, 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 get on the piece. All right, there we go. Right there. All right, there we go. Just like that. Get in there. Go in your hole. So, as you guys have probably seen, I like to work with gravity, build constructs that utilize gravity. And you may have seen a couple of images of it briefly here. But anyway, images of the new build, but there's the catapult that I built, and there's the second one. It works pretty well, excuse me. And then I've got my door bridge up there, and then this big huge ice build that you see behind you. Throw that guy in there. Ooh, I didn't expect that. I should have, but I wasn't. Stuck piece there. There we go. If you guys get a stuck piece of lumber, what you want to do, if you can, is get it out to the edge of your base and out into the grass or whatever that is. That will usually free it up and it'll just pop right out of the ground. Works with long boards and all that other stuff. The difficult thing is to get it over there. Occasionally the piece of lumber that's stuck in the ground will think that it's like somehow it can't leave the square of the plot within your base, the expansion piece that it's in, I guess it would be. I don't know. I think you understand what I'm trying to say. So like whenever you buy additional land, it will come out in like a certain size square, however many units big, the same size itself as whatever it was when you very first bought your first plot of land. And come on, get in there. Get in there. There we go. Okay. But anyway, sometimes the piece of lumber will get stuck in like whatever that square is, say this square right here, right? I think it's actually bigger than that. I think it's like that. But anyway, it'll get stuck in there. And so you'll like go to drag it out, and but it won't want to go past that line even though there's nothing there. It's just more of your own land. And in those cases where it's like, say, stuck over in here and you can't get it out anywhere, then just build a small blueprint on it and fill it up, and it will get turned into whatever that blueprint is, and then you can get rid of it at least. Alright, so here we go. We are going to go ahead and move these guys. Actually, I should probably stand on top. Okay, ready. Incoming. All right. Move. Where are you at? Where are you at? Can't see you. Ah, there you are. Okay. All right, so one. Sorry guys, this takes me a little bit of concentration here. Ah. Alright, let's see here. I think I need a bigger screen or something. Yeah, this is the kind of boring part, but the physics in the end are going to be fun. So a while back I saw a video posted by none other than Mr. Haskins himself, Good Primate, about glitch building a circle out of a series of wedges. And the circle he built was really cool. I was like, oh, okay, that's great. That's how you could actually make a circle in here. But it got me thinking. I couldn't quite figure out how to take that and turn it into a convex circle. You know, the outside of a circle, basically. What he was showing was like a hole. And I was like, well, I want to make like a circle because I want to make like... I want to do this thing with a ramp that goes a certain way. And so I did a Google search on how to make a convex circle in Lumber Tycoon. And I saw a video from that was actually posted on the Wikia page about a gentleman that had a young gentleman that had shown how to make circles, and he wasn't glitch building. I mean, he was just kind of building them as intended, I guess would be the way to put it. I was like, oh, okay, that's how he did it. And you start off from, you know, say if you're using a 4x4 as an initial wedge, you go from a 4x4 to a 3x4 to a 2x4 to a 1x4, and you position them where the skinny point of one of the wedges is touching the top of the thick point of the other wedge at the point where it would start going down at the angle towards the single little point. I don't know whatever it's called, but you'll see here in a second. Alright, there we go. Alright, so the wedges go. I've got them in groups of like three or four of them, but so basically it's, you know, 4x4s, 4x4s, and then 3x4s, 3x4s, and then 2x4s, and then 1x4s or whatever. Actually, the 1x4s are down here because of the angle I wanted to make everything, but that's what it is. So, what this is the start of is I need to buy some more land and bring it out here. Some more, as far, probably as far as I can. I want to kind of make it go maybe possibly into a loop. That would be really cool, a little barrel roll type thing. But at least come out and come up a little bit higher and just launch you out as far as you can. So this is where I'm at so far. We'll go ahead and take you up. We'll show you what we've got going on here. No problem. Wanna ride the ramp again? I got F. I'm gonna write it in the meantime. All right, so here we go. There it is. Sorry if that was kind of loud, guys. But yeah, that's the ramp. So wanna make it eventually come out and, you know, jump you a little bit higher probably, because I think if I just kind of bring this up a little bit higher, probably at about here, I might land halfway past the rock, like land halfway past the rock, close to the wood store. At least that's my estimation. Maybe I can get it to land on top of the rock over here. But yeah, so I'm gonna put some side rails on here. Going down, probably wires or something, maybe just walls, I'm not really sure. And then up here, so yeah, that'll all be closed off, at least to where you can't get to it from the ground. But over here, you come up the ladder, and this will be kind of like a waiting line, like at an amusement park ride or something. So you come over here, and then you'll come over like this, right? And then you'll get in, you'll be able to get in the vehicle or whatever. And then I'll probably have some hatches or maybe some conveyor belts or something that'll be like on a delay timer that will, after the car is respawned, it will cause the conveyors to, you know, wait a few moments and then start pushing the car out. So, you know, somebody can trigger it with a pressure plate or something like that, and it'll respawn the car, and they can wait a second, hop in, and just ride the ride. No whitelist needed. So that's the plan. All right, don't need these here. This was something else I was working on that I decided to scrap. This door here, we can get rid of that. Don't need that. We can get rid of that. But yeah, so like, oh, okay. So like this right here, these are 1x1s, right? And then I think that, yeah, that's our, sorry, 1x4. And then it should be a 2x4, right? And then a 3x4, or no, another 2x4. And then a 3x4 right here. Come on. Sorry, I don't want to fall off the edge. So 3x4, another 3x4, and then 4x4s. Right, and then I did a few of those here. So I did like five of them. And then right here I did some 3x4s, but I turned them the other way. Okay. So I could start going more down, right? And then here's 2x4s also going that same other way. And then some threes, and then some fours again. And threes the other way, or back the original way. Twos, and then ones. And then these are actually just tiles that I had to glitch build into the 1x1s, or 1x4s. And that was because of lack of planning on my part. I didn't think about how, if I wanted to come down smooth onto a tile, that I should start where I started up there at the top, built on all the way down this way. And so I should have thought about, you know, that one little piece of gap there, maybe come up one gap before I started all of that or something. And then I would have had to glitch build it in. But it worked out all right. Looks pretty good, I think. You could hardly tell it was glitch built in. I mean, but that is a, here, I'll show you. Let's see it right there. See it right there. So, that's it right there. Anyway, that's what it does. It shoots you off over there. And yeah, that was probably about 3 or 4 days. I did want to get a video to you guys about it beforehand. I honestly was torn about it, you know, how I wanted to do it, because I wanted to be able to show it all, you know, pretty well at once. But I didn't want to have like a 3-hour video, even sped up or whatever. So anyway, there it is. I hope you guys enjoyed it. See how Brendan is doing over here. Yeah, he's working on a shop over here. Let's see how he's doing. No shop. Okay, so he doesn't. He's not ready yet. Okay. Got going in there. Looks like some stairs and a bunch of stuff. Let's see what else we got here. We'll open that door maybe. Close door. Open door. Hello. Door doesn't open. Bedroom area up here, living room area, bathroom. So this is like a little studio apartment here. Right? Yep, little studio apartment. Got some extra wires. Got some lights. Lots of axes. So what else? Ooh, got candies. Nom nom nom. Oh, wait, there's Bolden Brash. Wait, I've got to find it. Where to go?
Bold and brash.
Bold and brash. All right, well, let's do outro. Outro time. Let's do it here with Squidward. Alright, well, thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And have yourself a great day and a wonderful Thanksgiving.